other related story today is about colonial education in Africa. I shall illustrate this with the story of Mungo Park and how he allegedly discovered River Niger, our River Niger. For centuries, Africa has been a beneficiary, if you like, a victim of Western education. In our elementary school days, we were taught that Mungo Park discovered River Niger. What really happened? Mungo Park, the European, came to Africa on expedition and he penetrated the continent of Africa through the big river. And as he traveled on this big river, he had problems, he had challenges. And at a point, sang some beautiful songs.
I have no father in this land. I have no mother in this land. I sleep in the night when the moon was shining at the bank of Niger River. At the bank of Niger River. At the bank of Niger River. I sleep in the night when the moon was shining at the bank of Niger River. And so Mungo Park sang, and innocent children that we were, we cried, we wept. This nice man who helped to discover our River Niger, who was suffering this much, that was colonial education for you. It took several years later, when we got to higher levels of education, when we started reflecting, that we realized, we started asking questions. How come that Mungo Park was the one who discovered our River Niger? The River Niger, where people fish, where they traveled, the River Niger around which people lived, they use it to irrigate their farms. How possible? Does it mean that these people have been living for years and centuries on the banks of River Niger, never knew that there was a river, and they were using it? But what really happened? During that period, the Europeans referred to the African continent as the dark continent because they knew nothing about Africa. So they set up expeditions. Their rich men put money together to send people to Africa to discover this so-called dark continent. And so Mungo Park came with the support of the rich and wealthy people in Europe. At that period, there were no aircraft. You travel only by sea. So Mungo Park came through the ocean, through the Atlantic Ocean. And then how will you penetrate this continent? They had to look for a river big enough to travel through the continent. And that was how they picked on this river, River Niger. And that's how Mungo Park traveled through River Niger. And along the way, he got himself killed. So sorry. But Europeans never give up. They sent other people to complete the job. And that's how the Landers brothers came to complete the travels and expedition of Mungo Park. And they were able now to travel through this River Niger until they got to the coast. And what followed that? What followed that was what? Slave trade, colonialism, neocolonialism. And today we talk about globalization, different faces of the same thing. Now, we have to reflect on this. There are lessons to learn from the Europeans. Europeans don't give up easily until they accomplish their task. There are lessons for this for Africa. Then their rich people put money together for research and for discoveries. Our leaders also have lessons to learn from this. And so, ladies and gentlemen, education in Africa and the dimension of indigenous education. Thank you.